This is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
And good morning, early risers. We have made it to Friday, limping here in some cases. It is 5 o'clock. I'm Ray Collins. Glad you're with us. And John, glad you're here as well. How are you doing?
I'm doing great, Ray. Thank you very much. Looking forward to sleeping in tomorrow.
Oh, me too. That's right.
It's going to be nice, right?
Yeah, actually, I can tomorrow. I'm going to be hosting an event in Lakewood Ranch for a 5K race. More on that throughout the show.
You're running in it?
I was going to, but I got so sick this week, I'm not going to be able to run after all. That's my excuse this year.
Well, it should be beautiful weather for it. That's the good news.
Oh, good. Good to hear. Yeah.
We're looking at some very pleasant conditions across the Sun Coast. Humidity has come up just a little bit. You have a few fair weather clouds in the forecast over the weekend. But basically, we are looking at very pleasant weather right straight through the period, with temperatures in the afternoon warm but not hot, and in the evenings cool and crisp. So some pretty nice conditions. Now, taking a look at the satellite view right now, you can see a few clouds over on the other coast. This is, I could have used this satellite view from 3 days ago, and you would not have been able to tell the difference. This big ridge of high pressure holding fast right across the region, bringing temperatures in the mid-60s to most of the area. We'll have a daytime high today that tops out maybe a degree warmer, coming in around 84 or so, hit 83 yesterday. And otherwise, just lots of sunshine, little chance of rain. Back to you, Ray.
Thank you, John. Checking First Alert traffic. Pretty good right now in Manatee County. One little buildup on this end of your, on the bottom of your screen there as you head south on 301 toward, Fruitville Road. Let's go farther south and check the map in Sarasota County. A little buildup there on 41 south of Clark as you head toward Osprey. Otherwise, no problems. And farther south, nothing much to speak of at 502 on your Friday morning. We are learning more about a van fire on I-75 nearly 2 weeks ago in Osprey. The Sarasota County Sheriff's Office has charged a Hillsborough County man in the death of his girlfriend, who is also the mother of their three children. Our Rick Adams has the story.
It's just not something I would have ever pictured him doing.
Rashad Bin Mohammed of Brandon has known 34-year-old Michael Clark since their high school days. He's in disbelief over the news that Clark has been arrested for the murder of his longtime girlfriend, Kristen Kelly.
Known him for a long time. You know, he's a jokester, a little bit of a clown. You know, he always likes to go out, have fun, fun-loving kid. It's really, really sad what happened.
The Sarasota County Sheriff's Office says the investigation began on October 15th when they found Kelly's dead body inside a burning minivan along I-75 in Sarasota County. Clark was the driver of the vehicle, and he says he didn't know how the fire began or how Kelly had died.
Through investigative means, we were able to determine that he is the one who beat his girlfriend and the mother of his kids to death. Put her in the back of his own vehicle, drove her to Sarasota, set his car on fire for the purpose of destroying evidence of his own crimes.
Clark is charged with murder, arson, tampering with evidence, and possession of cocaine. He had worked at this barber shop in Brandon. None of his co-workers would come on camera to comment, but Bin Mohammed says he would get his haircuts from Clark.
He's my barber. He's been cutting my hair for a long time. Obviously not in the past month, but he has his kids at the shop all the time, and they're, you know, good, happy, fun-loving kids.
In Sarasota County, I'm Rick Adams, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
On to other news now. The city of Northport looking toward the future. They're trying to project how many fire stations the city will need as population continues to grow. Currently, about 60,000 people live in Northport, but that is expected to grow to about 200,000 in the next 20 years.
You're looking at somewhere near 12 fire stations to cover a city this size, and with that, more than doubling the people that we have on board today.
Much of that growth will happen in the West Villages of Northport. That's where the Atlanta Braves are building a new spring stadium site. The developer has agreed to build a fire station there as well. Northport police addressing concerns parents have about an incident with a student at a middle school yesterday. Police say a student ran away from Woodland Middle into the nearby woods after he made a threatening comment. Police investigated and said his comments are not considered a credible threat. An extra officer will be on campus today just as a safety precaution. Also today, a disaster recovery center opens this morning for 4 days in Bradenton to help those affected by Hurricane Irma. These centers offer in-person support to individuals and small business owners. Recovery specialists from FEMA, the U.S. Small Business Administration, and the state of Florida will be on hand to help anyone willing to fill out applications or update their status. So here's where you go. It's the G.T. Bray Park Tennis Area on 33rd Avenue in Bradenton. It'll be open today, tomorrow and Monday from 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. and on Sunday from 9 a.m. to 1 p.m. Well, after a soft opening over the summer, a new hotel on Sarasota's Bayfront has their official grand opening now. The Westin is adjacent to the controversial View condo project close to the street at the corner of U.S. 41 and the Ringling. The Westin has 255 rooms, a full spa, and also a rooftop pool and bar. The hotel owners say about half their customers will come from business and convention-based, and the rest will be vacationers and leisure travelers. Police in Sarasota asking for your help to help sort out a stabbing at a bar last April. The incident happened at the Bon Bon restaurant, bar, and lounge on 301 North near Newtown. A victim suffered permanent injury. Well, police arrested 18-year-old Jose Lozada Alvarez and charged him with aggravated battery, but they believe others were involved, and they're asking now for more witnesses to please come forward. Happening now in Florida, Vice President Mike Pence was in Orlando discussing President Trump's tax reform plans. You can see him here arriving at Orlando International Airport. He's along with the Agricultural Secretary, Sonny Perdue, and they are meeting with Governor Rick Scott as well as local business leaders in the central Florida area to discuss the need for federal tax reform. Florida zoo officials say the nation's oldest female jaguar in captivity died at the age of 22. The Palm Beach Zoo said the jaguar was diagnosed with a kidney problem in January and underwent a medical procedure yesterday that confirmed that she had cancer. Now, zoo officials said they didn't want her to live in pain, so they decided to not bring her back from anesthesia. She had a 12-year-old daughter also at the zoo. Officials say she also has 16 living descendants and is responsible for producing 3% of the 121 jaguars currently living in zoos in this country, and 11% of all the jaguars found throughout North America. Very productive life. A ban on dog racing in Florida is among the dozens of new proposals being filed by members of the Florida Constitution Revision Commission. The commission has the power to directly place amendments on the ballot for next year. Now, supporters of the ban say the move comes as an opportunity to end the mistreatment of greyhounds and reduce the amount of gambling in Florida. Amendments placed on next year's ballot will need support of 60% of voters to be enacted. The Sarasota Kennel Club, of course, will be directly affected if this ban becomes law. We're learning more about the suspect behind that Manhattan terror attack that killed 8 people and injured 13 others. Investigators believe that Saifullah Saipov was planning the attack specifically on Halloween Day for nearly a year. They also found several knives and notes pledging allegiance to ISIS. Neighbors who knew the suspect say he was reserved and his family was not overly religious. The suspect was not on any terrorist watch list. He was likely radicalized after he moved to this country from Uzbekistan back in 2010.
What I'm hopeful is that we'll be able to perhaps do a psychological profile here and learn what makes these people tick. When do they cross over that line?
Now, after the attack, city officials in New York have placed concrete barriers along the bike path where that attack took place. Caught on camera, a kidnapping victim made a daring escape from the trunk of her alleged captor's car. Watch this now. Police in Alabama say the man broke into the woman's home and kidnapped her. When he stopped at the gas station though and got out, watch this, she pops the trunk and gets out and runs for help. Now you can even see as she comes in the gas station where he is, once he sees her coming in the gas station, Timothy Wyatt, he runs right back out. He is now in police custody, charged with robbery, kidnapping, and domestic violence. Well, 2 months ago, the city of Houston was under several feet of water. But now the city is celebrating its first ever World Series title. What a year they've had there. Reporter Deborah Wrigley says the baseball success was well-timed.
Touchdown at Bush Airport, a hero's homecoming.
Houston Astros!
On board the team that made us believe and certainly earned it. And don't forget that carry-on item, the commissioner's trophy, hoisted proudly above by MVP George Springer, who brought it home.
I love them.
The team, their families, and Astros staff boarded buses for the final trek home. Escorted by police along 59 South, everyone seemed to know who was inside, some even dangerously stopping along the road to cheer. Then a glimpse of the city skyline. lit in Astros colors, office windows spelling pride, and home sweet home field.
Woo!
Where fans couldn't wait until tomorrow's parade to cheer.
We're very proud of them. We've been through thick and thin. We were there through the 100 losses. We were there all the time, and we're here now.
The players becoming household names in Houston.
Oh, I've been an Astros fan since we arrived, and I'm just so excited because, you know, to see a World Series. We were at that fifth game, too, which was amazing.
First words for some fans. Birthday memories, too.
It's very crazy because they won, and it was like the best present ever.
And a lasting legacy.
There's times where I was heart attack, but we got it. We earned history. We made history, so that's all that matters.
Now, some diehard Astros fans named the Roystons were excited to add a fourth fan to their growing family. But Lindsay Royston wasn't due until Tuesday. With that in mind, her husband Chad, who was in L.A. rooting for the Astros, he went to Game 6 and had tickets for Game 7. But on the morning of Game 7, Lindsay said she woke up with contractions. After texting her husband, he managed to get a flight back home before the game and arrived with 15 minutes to spare.
It was 2-0 when she was born. And she came right during the game. Springer hits a home run to seal it off. Just, it was awesome, epic.
I would say so. The couple has yet to decide on a name for their little baby. Maybe George, in honor of the MVP, George Springer.
That's funny.
That guy's a baseball fan.
It's lucky he got an plane. I mean,
I know.
It's tough to do at the last minute.
Can you imagine that call? He has to leave Game 7,
Yeah. Come
back to Houston, but for a very good reason.
Well, the good news is that Game 7 was over pretty early on, I guess. So.
That's true. The first few innings, that's right.
It would have, Game 6, it would have been a tougher,
tougher
call for
that's
him.
That's right.
Anyway, some very pleasant weather coming your way this weekend. Talk about it in a sec.
Also, First Alert traffic and a closer look at plans for Sarasota's Bayfront. We'll talk to the actual design firm in Boston chosen to draw up ideas. And a look at President Trump's agenda as he heads to the Far East.
My name's Greg Simone, president and founder of Care to Try. I'm excited to announce that this year we're hosting our inaugural 5K and 1 mile race. In addition, we are attempting to set a Guinness Book of World Records for the most amount of wheelchairs in a race. This is a call to action and we need your help. We'd like to set an environment where everybody's accepted. So please come out and join us in Wheel Unified. The event will be hosted on November 4th, 2017 at Lakewood Ranch CrossFit. Please go to our website, caretotry.org, where there are details for race sign-up.
Being the caregiver for my husband is truly a blessing, but sometimes it's easy to lose a part of myself. To be my best, for him and for me, it's important to have time to be able to recharge. When I called Tidewell Hospice, they gave me the chance to do just that. They helped me find the time to care for myself, all the while with the peace of mind of knowing my husband is in the very best hands. Tidewell Hospice, it's more than you think.
Enjoy fine wine, craft beer, and delicious foods, all while supporting a great cause at the 16th annual Suncoast Food and Wine Festival presented by Publix, Saturday, November 11th from 1 to 4 p.m. at the Sarasota Polo Club. Taste wines from around the world and sample cuisine from the area's finest restaurants. All proceeds benefit a variety of local charities and Rotary Club projects. For tickets and information, visit suncoastfoodandwinefest.com.
Are you currently on Medicare? In other words, do you carry the red, white, and blue Medicare card? If so, are you suffering from chronic back pain? If you answered yes, you may be eligible for a pain-relieving back brace covered by Medicare at little to no cost, shipped directly to your home for free. These medical-grade back braces are ideal for lower back pain, arthritis, spinal disorders, and other chronic back problems. Will you qualify for a medical-grade back brace?
Call Back Brace America at 1-800-683-9262.
This is the story of a boy who is very sensitive to lights and sounds. So he built secret hiding places where nothing could get in. The boy didn't like looking people in the eye. It made him feel uncomfortable. One day, he found out he had something called autism. His family got him help. And slowly, he learned how to live with it better.
Early intervention can make a lifetime of difference. Learn the signs at autismspeaks.org.
Now your ABC 7 First Alert weather forecast with meteorologist John Scalzi.
Coming in with a 65 degree air temperature, a dew point coming in at 62. We have a lot of clear sky out there right now and almost a full moon. So it's a very pretty start to the day as you take a look up and enjoy all the starshine and the moonlight out there. As we head into the next 24 hours, 36 hours, probably pick up a few extra clouds around. But for the most part, we are looking at an absolutely beautiful, mostly sunny to sunny weekend. Absolutely spectacular November weekend. Northeast wind comes in at about 6 right now. That northeast wind will be with us on and off throughout the entire weekend, maybe switching a little more easterly at times, but generally with that east-northeast component. 63 in Parrish, Wauchula, Mayaca coming in at 63, Arcadia the same. Lakewood Ranch at 64, Longbow Key at 67, Venice at 65, Inglewood at 66. You folks in Northport have 64. And down in Punta Gorda, 66 degrees there. We have across the nation, kind of inclement, unsettled weather over a large portion of the United States, particularly along this front right now that extends all the way up into Canada and all the way down into Texas. Now, that frontal boundary will be a focal point for shower and thunderstorm activity, and it's very mild to the north where this front has not moved through yet. New York City experiencing some very warm temperatures, but back behind it there is some cooler air and we're seeing some snow showers along the upper tier. Back to the Pacific Northwest, more showers still in progress, especially along the Pacific Northwest coastline. But for us, it's all about that high pressure ridge and will be right straight through the weekend with some very pleasant weather and an easterly wind. Now we may pick up a little higher humidity, which could lead to some patchy fog as we head into the weekend, but that's the worst of it. I don't see anything that means rain showers this weekend. Northeast wind at about 10 to 15, 2-foot seas, light chop, and the forecast calls for very nice weather straight through the weekend. And don't forget, oh, I forgot to move the clock. Don't you forget to move the clock. You move that clock back on Sunday morning, right?
Okay, thank you, John. Let's check First Alert traffic right now as you awaken on this Friday morning. We'll see you in Manatee County. Nothing much to speak of at this hour of the day. Let's go farther south into Sarasota. A few issues there along the bayfront, perhaps 41 southbound where it's called Mound as it goes toward the 301 split. Also Bee Ridge Road as you get near Beneva in the eastbound lane. South County all clear at 518 now on your Friday morning. For years, many have said more could be done along the Sarasota Bayfront around the Van Wezel. Now plans are going to the next stage with a design firm chosen to suggest a master plan for that area. Here's a closer look. It may be one of the most underutilized pieces of bayfront land on the Gulf Coast of Florida. Several city blocks and not a lot usually going on here. 42 acres of prime real estate on Sarasota's bayfront. So what's going to happen here?
If you ask passersby like Mike Walders, he hopes to see a lot of new buildings here.
It helps out with the economy. The economy revolves around people working.
But if you ask nearby resident Janice Stafford, she hopes this area remains peaceful.
I'd like to see more plantings and more, and maybe some sort of, maybe a playground for some kids or something, but not huge buildings now.
Whether this area becomes buildings or a playground will largely be up to the Sarasota Bayfront Planning Organization, a nonprofit board of local business leaders who are now renting out this nearby city-owned building. Over the past few years, the group that used to call itself Bayfront 2020 and now goes by The Bay has held dozens of meetings, public forums, and taken notes on what residents want. One recent survey concluded most people want a boardwalk, an outdoor performance area, and art sculptures.
And it's just an extraordinary set of sort of puzzle pieces that we're excited to start playing with.
Just a few weeks ago, the local committee hired a master planning firm from Boston named Sasaki. And after one look, designers we talked to via Skype said they're not surprised the city wants to do more with this land.
Oh, absolutely. It feels very, very underutilized.
But one big question is still looming large. Should this be a quiet area that's maintained as a park-type atmosphere, or perhaps a bustling nightlife center?
How about all of the above? How about a little bit of everything? And I think that is really one of the keys to activation.
Fair enough. But keep in mind, just a couple blocks south, there's a billion-dollar project also in the works, once again called the Quay, that is also in the planning stages. The Quay will be privately funded. But who will pay for this city project?
A great question, Ray.
Sarasota City Manager Tom Barwin says it'll be a mix of public and private dollars.
Most major metropolitan entertainment facilities have a blend of financing.
And speaking of entertainment facilities, what does the future hold for the centerpiece of this redevelopment, the 50-year-old Van Wezel Performing Arts Center?
It's something that's going to have to be discussed. It's a sensitive topic, obviously, and it certainly, you know, will need improvement. Whether raising it is the answer, I don't think we know that yet.
One board member told me off the record it would probably be replaced by a larger facility and eventually get knocked down. When pressed, City Manager Tom Barwin gave two very different answers.
I think the Van Wezel and its identity as a cultural center is certainly going to survive. That's one of the reasons this whole initiative has been undertaken.
Certainly going to survive, but then 2 minutes later he said this.
You know, these are decisions that have yet to be made.
And Barwin says despite years of public input, you can expect more public input in the coming months.
Do you think it'll ever break ground?
I believe there will be ground broken within, you know, the next few years.
Few years would be 2020, as in Bayfront 2020. Coincidence after all. Still ahead, good morning, Suncoast. The iPhone 10 will be available in stores today. We'll have a preview for you. And next half hour, local reaction to the president's tax reform plan.
Let me introduce you to the ultimate Florida window. Do you feel safer with this
or this?
You'll be proud too.
Buy more, save more. Volume discounts on four or more windows.
Is your mop a dirty, disgusting mess? You need the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System, the only mop and bucket that spins the dirt away. A system that cleans practically anything and everything with super absorbent microfiber. Dip it in the washer side and the mess releases into the bucket. Then place it in the dryer side and push on the pedal. You get a clean mop head that's practically dry and ready for more. And your hands will never again touch a dirty, disgusting mop. The heads are washable and reusable. Get the Hurricane 360 Spin Mop System for just two payments of $19.99. You'll also get a Sticky Buddy, the reusable sticky roller that picks up pet hair and lint and washes clean in seconds. You can take advantage of our 2-for-1 pick it up special and get a second spin mop set. Just pay additional shipping and fee. And we'll upgrade you to free priority handling. So don't wait. Order now.
Call 1-800-394-1524 to get your Hurricane Spin Mop double offer. So hurry and call 1-800-394-1524. Call now.
Are you a soccer mom or dad? Regardless of their age or experience level, when your kids play soccer or any other sport, there's one person on the sideline who is key to help recognize and seek medical care for sports-related concussion. It's you. You need to know the signs and symptoms of concussion, and you need to act if you think your child has been injured. Remember, when in doubt, sit them out. To learn more, go to cdc.gov/concussion. 1001, 1002, 1003, 1004.
Of the Westin that opens officially today and has events right up till next week. They had a soft opening over the summer. A lot of folks have been there since, and today's the official grand opening right there at the corner at 41 and the Ringling Causeway. The view is adjacent to it, and the Ritz-Carlton is behind it. So that's quite a busy spot and getting busier by the year. And that's a scene right there. There's a live picture for you. If you've got any pictures to send our way, don't forget our Facebook page. I had a chance to catch the sunset last night along the bayfront, and I posted several pictures. So if you go onto Facebook and go to Ray Collins, ABC7, and like the page, you'll see the pictures I took. And feel free to comment and rate, and I'll be sure to write back to you as well. Also, don't forget our app. You can update the app now. Go to the App Store at WWSB or My Suncoast, and you update the latest and get breaking news delivered right to your phone. And speaking of your phone, today is the big debut of the iPhone X. So, what's new with this one? ABC's Candace Gibson and Diane Macedo have a preview.
In today's Tech Bites, the new iPhone on sale. Customers in Australia were the first to get their new iPhone 10 this morning.
And here in the U.S., Apple fanatics are lined up all across the country. The company says it expects sales of the new phone to fuel its most profitable quarter ever.
Some people in Tennessee are enjoying the brilliant colors of autumn for the first time, getting emotional thanks to the help of some special lenses.
A lookout point in the Smoky Mountains recently installed high-tech viewfinders for the colorblind, so they can now see that fall foliage. And Lego lovers have a chance to live out a fantasy. One family can win a night in Denmark's 25 million brick Lego house.
Airbnb is co-sponsoring the contest. Candidates have to answer the simple question. If you and your family had an infinite supply of Lego bricks, what would you build?
Ooh, an iPhone 10, then you wouldn't have to wait online.
Or the $1,000 price tag.
Those are your Tech Bites.
Have a good one.
Tech Bites, brought to you by Anoro.
COPD makes it hard to breathe. So to breathe better, I go with Anoro.
Go your own way.
COPD tries to say go this way. I say I'll go my own way with Anoro.
Go your own way.
Once daily Anoro contains two medicines called bronchodilators that work together to significantly improve lung function all day and all night. Anoro is not for asthma. It contains a type of medicine that increases risk of death in people with asthma. The risk is unknown in COPD. Anoro won't replace rescue inhalers for sudden symptoms and should not be used more than once a day. Tell your doctor if you have a heart condition, high blood pressure, glaucoma, prostate, bladder, or urinary problems. These may worsen with Anoro. Call your doctor if you have worsened breathing, chest pain, mouth or tongue swelling, problems urinating, vision changes, or eye pain while taking Anoro.
Ask your doctor about Anoro.
Get your first prescription free at Anoro.com.
You studied hard, went to college, and achieved your dream, but it turned into a financial nightmare. If you have federal student loans and you'd like to reduce your payments, get more time, or have your loans completely eliminated, then we have good news. With one call to Student Loan Relief Services, you can find support and guidance. We've already helped thousands of people, and we can help you too. If you have $10,000 or more in federal student loans, you can qualify for payment extensions, payment reductions, or you may qualify to have your federal student loan completely forgiven. Call Student Loan Relief Services now to find out about your options. Take control of your finances and get out from under this burden. One of our student loan experts has the answers to your questions and great solutions to ease your financial burden. We're here for you. Call Student Loan Relief Services now.
Call 800-759-0203, 800-759-0203.
Attention type 2 diabetics. The FDA warns of an increased risk of amputation associated with certain diabetes medications. If you took the diabetes medications Invokana or Invokamet and then suffered an amputation or one of these other serious injuries, call the Rely On Group right now. If you've suffered amputation or any of these injuries after taking your diabetes medication, call the Rely On Group today. You may be entitled to substantial financial compensation. The FDA has recently warned about an increased risk of leg and foot amputations associated with the use of certain diabetic medications, such as Invokana and Invokamet. If you or a loved one took the diabetes medications Invokana or Invokamet and then suffered an amputation, ketoacidosis, kidney failure, or even death, call the Rely On Group now. We are here to help you get the justice you deserve. You may be entitled to substantial financial compensation. Call 800-355-8205. That's 800-355-8205.
If you're only hungry for a slice of apple pie, why buy the whole pie? And you certainly wouldn't want to pay for an all-you-can-eat buffet. So if you don't use your cell phone that much, why get charged for a plan that's too big or even an unlimited plan? Luckily, there's still a wireless company that shares your values. Welcome to Consumer Cellular. Our average customer pays about $25 a month for everything they need. Many pay even less, as plans start at just $15 a month. You'll get a straightforward bill that's easy to understand with no surprises and all the attention you deserve from our friendly customer service team. No wonder Consumer Cellular has received the J.D. Power Award for highest customer service 3 times in a row. Plus, if you're an AARP member, you'll receive special discounts. It's easy to switch. You can even keep your phone and your number. So stop paying for more than you need and start your 30-day risk-free trial today.
Call 800-457-2317.
go online or visit a Target store today.
Check out My Suncoast Dining on MySuncoast.com for Chef Judy's favorite recipes, restaurant guide, and more. Go to MySuncoast.com/dining.
This half hour on Good Morning Suncoast, the president heads to the Far East this morning. We'll preview his agenda. Plus, helping the hungry in Manatee County. We'll have a preview of an event today in Lakewood Ranch. And Division I tennis comes to the area for an annual tournament. Those stories and more right now on Good Morning Suncoast.
Live from the ABC 7 studios, this is Good Morning Suncoast. We're here for you.
And good morning. It is 5:30 right now on your Friday morning. I'm Ray Collins. It should be a beautiful weekend for all these events going on. Let's get right to that forecast. Here's the bearer of good news, John Scalzi.
Yes, I am the bearer of good news. I don't see any problems at all this weekend. It's going to be a little bit warmer. That's the only perhaps negative side if you're planning on doing any kind of athletics out of doors and we're looking forward to those mid-70s. You won't find it this weekend. It'll probably be mid-80s, but still not uncomfortable relative humidity. We'll detail that forecast in a few. Right now, cloud cover across the region is pretty much at a minimum. We have some clouds out over Atlantic waters, but nothing locally that's causing a problem. Certainly nothing producing any rainfall today. 63, Wauchula, Arcadia, Myakka, Parrish, Bradenton, Northport. You get the picture. Temperatures are generally hovering in the lower to mid-60s and inland areas in mid to upper 60s right along the coastline with 67 Longboat Key and 65 in Sarasota. Day planner calls for a temperature that climbs into the low to mid 80s by the afternoon. I think many locations are going to see 83, 84 degrees for a high temperature today. Complete forecast coming up in a few. Ray?
It's a beautiful time of year. Thank you, John. Let's check the roads right now. Pretty quiet. As you might expect, this hour of the day in Manatee County, nothing to speak of. Farther south, we'll check into Sarasota County. A little blip there on 41 as you get south of Clark Road around McIntosh. You'll see some buildup there and some congestion around the Osprey and the Oaks complex there. Let's go farther south down one more notch and check out South County. Nothing much to report at 5:32 on your Friday morning. Our top story this half hour, President Trump this morning will stop in Hawaii. On his way to the Far East, it's a big trip. ABC's Janae Norman has our preview.
President Trump's first official trip to Asia, likely to be dominated by trade issues and tensions surrounding North Korea's missile and nuclear weapons program, telling Fox News' Laura Ingraham.
We have one problem that's a very big problem. It's called North Korea. China has been helpful. We are talking trade with China.
During the trip that includes stops in Beijing, Seoul, and Tokyo, President Trump hopes Republicans back home make strides on tax reform.
I'll be back in 11 days, but I know things will go well.
This is the beginning of the end of this horrible tax code in America. It's an exciting day.
The sweeping new tax bill cuts the number of tax brackets from 7 to 4, doubles the standard deduction for married couples, bringing it to $24,000, and it offers big potential breaks for the rich, like repealing the estate tax and a win for business by slashing corporate taxes from 35% to 20%. But American families could end up paying more with changes to popular tax breaks, like getting rid of the student loan interest deduction, writing off medical expenses, and cutting the mortgage interest deduction in half.
They're doing tax giveaways to the wealthy and the powerful, and telling the middle class, take a hike, you're on your own, baby.
Despite Republicans promising to cut the deficit, this plan is estimated to cost roughly $1.5 trillion over the next decade. And it's that price tag that even some Republicans aren't sold on. Janae Norman, ABC News, Washington.
We're now hearing the president did not dismiss the idea of arranging a meeting with Russia's president during his presidential campaign. That's according to one of his former campaign advisors. A court filing says that George Papadopoulos introduced the idea during a meeting last year. A person in that meeting says Trump did not say yes or no to meeting Putin. Current Attorney General Jeff Sessions reportedly shut the idea down, though. Papadopoulos pleaded guilty to lying to the FBI about interactions with foreign officials close to the Russian government. So far, it's the campaign's clearest connection to Russia's efforts to meddle in last year's elections. Investigators are now showing interest in President Trump's son-in-law in the dismissal of the FBI director. CNN has learned investigators are asking in witness interviews about Jared Kushner's role in the firing of James Comey. Kushner, of course, is married to first daughter Ivanka and is also a White House senior advisor. It's not clear how Kushner's advice to the president might relate to the overall Russia investigation or potential obstruction of justice. You might have noticed Suncoast Congressman Vern Buchanan right there in the left part of your screen while House Speaker Paul Ryan spoke about tax reform yesterday. Buchanan showed his support after legislation to fix the nation's tax code was introduced. He gave us this statement afterwards saying, "We are one step closer to meaningful tax reform that will benefit all Americans. This bill cuts taxes for middle-class families as well as small businesses, simplifies a broken tax code, and jumpstarts the economy." He said he looks forward to meeting with the constituents in the weeks ahead to discuss how the bill can be improved further as it makes its way through Congress. 5:36 right now, switching gears. Many of you are looking forward to the weekend, as are we. And once again, you have a wide range of choices here on the Suncoast. Our Linda Carson previews some ideas.
Be nice to your wallet and kick off your weekend with a great evening at Music on Main in Lakewood Ranch. Admission is free. Robin and the Retros will entertain with their 60s, 70s, and Motown sounds. And come by the ABC 7 booth and say hello to the gang.
And the 30th annual Taste of Manatee is coming to Rossi Park along the Riverwalk on Saturday. It starts at 11 a.m.
There's a great lineup of bands.
We have Kim Betts and the Gamble Street Band, Jaw Movement playing reggae, the Big Daddy Band, and the Bearded Brothers.
There'll be 20 local manatee restaurants and three culinary schools competing for trophies and bragging rights.
They're going to be competing for four different categories, actually. This year, we've added the best utilization of local ingredients.
And the Sarasota Opera opens its fall season Friday night with La Traviata.
Traviata is one of the most popular operas in the repertoire. It's by Verdi, and last year, after completing our Verdi cycle, in which we became the only company in the world to do all of Verdi's music, we had a year of rest from Verdi. So it's feels like the right thing to do is to bring back Verdi and bring him back with possibly his most performed opera.
La Traviata this weekend, Friday night at 7:30 and Sunday at 1:30 at the Sarasota Opera House.
The Sarasota Medieval Fair starts this weekend at the Sarasota County Fairgrounds and it continues on Saturdays and Sundays through November 19th.
You'll meet some interesting characters and see some amazing performances.
We have stage shows, we have lane performers, we have musicians, we have all kinds of shops and vendors, we have a children's realm.
And there'll be battles right out of the pages of medieval history.
We've got two human combat chess matches throughout the day, and both of them are different. All right, so this is where you'll see people in place of the pieces on the board, and when a piece wants to take another piece, they have to fight over the square. So it's swords, axes, daggers, stabs.
The jousting matches are always crowd favorites.
It's big men wearing full plates of armor, riding big horses and whacking each other with lances, and when someone gets knocked off, they really got knocked off.
And this year, they're telling the story of the young King Arthur. Is it fact or is it fantasy? Find out for yourself. Linda Carson, ABC 7, your Suncoast News.
Also starting today and going through the weekend, some of the best college tennis teams in the country will compete in Lakewood Ranch. The Intercollegiate Tournament will take place on the courts of Lakewood Ranch Golf and Country Club. This is an annual event that involves men's and women's tennis. The event ends with the finals on Sunday, and best of all, there is no admission charge. Hope to see you there. The Longboat Key is in both Sarasota and Manatee County. We know that. In fact, two-thirds of Longboat Key is in Sarasota, and a third, the northern tip, is in Longboat. Residents who live in Manatee County pay more. Town manager David Bullock says those on the northern tip are paying a combined $2.6 million more than those in Sarasota County, and they are not getting any additional services. Bullock says, as things stand now, it's having a hassle with two elections, two sheriff's offices, and having two different sets of county laws.
And if, you know, 95% of them say we'd like to be in this county or that county, then we know where our citizens are and we sort of have our mission at that point.
So the town of Longboat Key will discuss the issue with Manatee County's commission in February. Stay tuned. A big turnout yesterday for the annual Empty Bowls Luncheon, and another one is planned for today in Manatee County. Empty Bowls is a primary fundraiser benefiting the Food Bank of Manatee County, which the proceeds going back to the program. More than a dozen restaurants are taking part in yesterday's in downtown Bradenton and today's in Lakewood Ranch. Everyone who comes out gets their own bowl to take home and soup and bread as well. It demonstrates how together we can fill the empty bowls of our neighbors in need.
We have so many of our neighbors, hard to believe, that can't afford to put food on the table. So today's event, a great event with great soup and great restaurants here, will help us to fill the bowls of those in need.
So today's luncheon is at 11 o'clock to 1 p.m. on Main Street in Lakewood Ranch, held outdoors. The Food Bank of Manatee provides food to more than 100 social service agencies, food pantries, and soup kitchens across the area. And a strong finish for this year's sea turtle nesting season. Over 4,500 nests were recorded on beaches from Longboat Key down south to Venice. Over 4,400 were laid by threatened loggerhead sea turtles, while 79 were laid by threatened green sea turtles. Although the count didn't surpass the record set in 2016, it was the highest number of green sea turtle nests in 36 years of conservation efforts. Impressive numbers when you realize the dicey weather we've had the past 2 months.
Exactly. Yeah. Right. Irma didn't do too much damage, which is amazing. We've had tropical storms do more damage. So it just goes to show each storm is an individual entity, you know, and every one, depending on its angle of attack and the wind flow, can do different things with different wind speeds. We have across our region lovely weather. Let's forget about hurricanes for the weekend, shall we? Yeah, gorgeous weather over the weekend. We'll talk about it in a second.
All right, good to hear. Also, First Alert traffic and the latest in a new study that shows fruits and vegetables may contain remnants of pesticides. We'll tell you about which of the side effects you should watch out for next in Health Smart.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning, and services is qualified, and service calls are free. ANDServices.com.
Enjoy fine wine, craft beer, and delicious foods, all while supporting a great cause at the 16th annual Suncoast Food and Wine Festival presented by Publix, Saturday, November 11th from 1 to 4 p.m. at the Sarasota Polo Club. Taste wines from around the world and sample cuisine from the area's finest restaurants. All proceeds benefit a variety of local charities and Rotary Club projects. For tickets and information, visit suncoastfoodandwinefest.com.
This is an important medical announcement. Talcum powder products from some of the best-known brands have been linked to ovarian cancer. Any woman who has used a talcum powder product and has been diagnosed with ovarian cancer may be entitled to substantial compensation. Studies show that women with long-term use of talcum powder, including baby powder for feminine hygiene, can increase the risk of contracting ovarian cancer. Call now for a free assessment of your case and potential money damages. This call is confidential. There's no cost, and you may be eligible. Juries have awarded millions of dollars to women who should have been warned about the risks of ovarian cancer with long-term use of talcum powder. Call the talcum powder hotline. If you or a loved one used talcum powder and were diagnosed or died from ovarian cancer, you must call now.
Call 800-570-7599, 800-570-7599.
Today, everyone is looking for more fashionable choices in flooring than ever before. And G. Fried has responded with a huge selection of carpets, tile, wood, laminate, and vinyl. Installed by a highly skilled team, G. Fried has got everything you're looking for and more. The next time you think about quality flooring, think G. Fried Flooring America. G. Fried Flooring America. Our world is at your feet.
If you're between 50 and 85 years old, call the number on your screen right now for free information on how to save your family thousands of dollars. We're Family Love Plans, and we've been helping families just like yours for over 30 years. The average funeral today can cost up to $10,000 or more, but the most you'll get from government benefits is just $255. How will your family pay the difference? At Family Love Plans, we can help you and your family. Our senior plans start as low as just a dollar a day and pay up to $30,000 for a funeral and other final expenses. Peace of mind is easy. There's no medical exam and your plan can't be canceled. Better still, your rate will never go up and your benefits will never go down. Get your free information about our senior plans. Just answer a few simple questions and receive approval right over the phone.
Call 1-800-707-3608. That's 1-800-707-3608.
For your plumbing, electrical, or air conditioning and services is qualified and service calls are free. AndServices.com. AndServices.com.
Now your ABC 7 First Alert weather forecast with meteorologist John Scalzi.
A 65 degree air temperature, plenty of starlight out there, as well as almost a full moon. Full moon is technically after midnight tonight, so it's tomorrow is the full moon, but an absolutely exquisite sky. Dew point value coming in at 62. We have a wind that's light northeast at about 6. It's very pleasant out there. 65 degrees, Wachula, Arcadia, you've got 65 as well. Got a lot of 64s on the board. Bradenton Parish, Lakewood Ranch, Mayaca, all coming in at 64. At 65 degrees in Northport, Inglewood comes in at 67, so does Venice. Longboat Key, the hot spot, coming in at 69 degrees. So across the country, you have kind of an active weather map, actually. All of the weather pretty much riding along this frontal boundary that moves from California to down east Maine and dips down as low as Texas. Lots of rain shower activity along this frontal boundary. For us, though, high pressure is the dominant weather feature that's going to keep all of that frontal action at bay. We get the underbelly wind from that high pressure, which brings us a kind of an easterly wind flow. That easterly wind flow tends to take moisture off the Atlantic, pick up the moisture and sling it back in our direction. So that will bring us moderate humidity through the weekend, not really high, but then again, not as low as we had at the beginning of the week when we had almost desert-like relative humidities. Sunny skies for us, warm and dry, despite the fact that we may have a little bit of that higher humidity air in place right straight through the weekend. Could lead to a little patchy fog during the morning hours, particularly in northern and interior sections of the viewing area, but it's not going to be a big deal. Otherwise, I don't think we'll see much in the way of rainfall. Taking a look at the water vapor imagery, which shows you the swirls and motions in the atmosphere, where the dry air is, where it is not. The dry air indicated here by this kind of tan colorization, and it's still all over the upper atmosphere in the state of Florida. So the air aloft, too dry to support rain showers, despite the fact that we do have a little extra moisture at lower levels of the atmosphere. The future cast shows, well, not much in the way of any kind of rainfall activity for us. Now, the other coast, as we have seen over the last several days, may have a chance at seeing a slight little bit of drizzle from time to time, patchy drizzle from some of the clouds that move onshore from Atlantic waters. But look at the difference between, on this computer model, between Sunday's Atlantic waters, just kind of littered with little showers, and Gulf waters under the influence of this big ridge of high pressure. Absolutely, the sun is shining. So a pretty big switch between East Coast, West Coast, Florida over the course of the weekend. Titan radar not showing a drop of rain here. And again, if you're traveling today, there could be some inclement weather along this frontal boundary that stretches through the Ohio Valley and into easternmost Great Lakes. So just watch for that. Otherwise, things look good for boating today. Beautiful day to be out on the water. In fact, the entire weekend looks great on the water. Northeast wind with wind slightly elevated at 10 to 15, subsiding a bit this evening. 2 foot seas and a light chop, though, so not too terribly bad. And the forecast for the weekend looks great. Lots of sunshine, little chance of rain. And I moved that doggone clock. Moved it back to Sunday, so don't forget, 2 a.m. Sunday morning, we fall back 1 hour. Ray?
Very good. Thank you, John. Checking First Alert traffic in Manatee County. A little blip there on 301 North as you approach downtown Bradenton. Otherwise, pretty clear. Let's follow 301 South now. You'll see it has a slowdown there as you get to Fruitville Road almost. Bayfront still busy in the southbound lane as you approach the 301 split. Let's check farther south now to our friends in South County. A little blip there, 41 northbound as you approach Venice around River Road perhaps and Jacaranda. Otherwise, all clear at 549. Well, we all know we need to eat more fruits and vegetables, but a new study says what's on those fruits and vegetables could create issues, especially for those who want to become parents. Mary Maloney explains in today's Health Smart.
An essential part of any diet, fruit and vegetables. Yet some produce may come with a little something extra, pesticide residue. According to a study published in the Journal of the American Medical Association, eating fruit and veggies with high amounts of pesticide residue may lower your chance of pregnancy or cause pregnancy loss. The study looked at the diets of women undergoing infertility treatments. Based on the U.S. Department of Agriculture's pesticide data program, avocados, corn, and orange juice typically have a low amount of pesticide residue. Those with a high amount include peaches, strawberries, spinach, and peppers. Researchers say more stringent study is needed to determine the exact link between pesticides and pregnancy. But if you are trying to get pregnant, eat foods with a lower amount of pesticide residue or go organic. Just remember, that can be costly. Also, wash your produce under running water before you eat. For today's Health Minute, I'm Mary Maloney.
Good advice. Up next, your local news headlines and candy giant Hershey set to release their newest gold treat. We'll tell you when after this.
Need more space in your place? The More Space Place can help. With Murphy beds that disappear to reveal a home office, living room, or den. Custom closets with designated areas for your shoes, bags, wardrobe, and accessories. Custom-built entertainment centers, garage storage systems, and more. The More Space Place has three showrooms next to Sonny's on US 41 South in Sarasota, on Lakewood Ranch Boulevard just south of State Route 64 in Bradenton, and on Tamiami Trail next to Panera Bread in Port Charlotte. Put more space in your place at the More Space Place.
Rose takes her volunteering for Tidewell Hospice very seriously. But she knows how to have fun, too. And that's what she brings when we're invited to visit patients as part of Tidewell's pet therapy program. People love to see her. She really brightens their day. She makes people smile. And in end-of-life care, a smile can be a wonderful gift. Tidewell Hospice. It's more than you think.
What to do when your heating or air conditioning needs service or, heaven forbid, replacement? Call Air Now today. We've been serving Sarasota and Manatee County since 1946. We offer $49.95 tune-ups, lease or finance options, and remember, service today or it's free.
Are you currently on Medicare? In other words, do you carry the red, white, and blue Medicare card? If so, are you suffering from chronic back pain? If you answered yes, you may be eligible for a pain-relieving back brace covered by Medicare at little to no cost, shipped directly to your home for free. These medical-grade back braces are ideal for lower back pain, arthritis, spinal disorders, and other chronic back problems. Our accredited staff will handle all of the Medicare paperwork for free. And best of all, your brace is shipped directly to your home for free. Don't let chronic lower back pain slow you down. Get moving and stay active with a medical-grade back brace covered by Medicare at little to no cost. We also accept Blue Cross Blue Shield, United Healthcare, Aetna, Humana, and other insurance. Will you qualify for a medical-grade back brace covered by Medicare? Find out for free.
Call Back Brace America at 1-800-715-0835. That's 1-800-715-0835, 1-800-715-0835.
Let me introduce you to the ultimate Florida window. Do you feel safer with this or this? You'll be proud too.
Buy more, save more. Volume discounts on four or more windows.
Stay connected to your clients and new customers using ABC7 Digital Media Services. Our team of professionals provide a wide array of digital services to help you get the most out of your website. We specialize in building and helping you maintain the most effective digital solutions for your business. It's vital that your online presence stands out, so our experts will equip you with the best resources available. Trust ABC7 Digital Media Services to give you the right tools to grow your business.
Here are the headlines as you awaken on this Friday morning. We're learning more about a van fire on I-75 nearly 2 weeks ago in Osprey. The Sarasota County Sheriff's Office have charged this man from Hillsborough County in the death of his girlfriend and mother of their three children. A disaster recovery center opens today in Bradenton to help those affected by Hurricane Irma. It'll be at the G.T. Bray Park and remain open through Monday. And the Empty Bowls Luncheon will be held today, 11 a.m. to 1 p.m. on Main Street in Lakewood Ranch today. Those taking part get to keep the bowls. A dozen area restaurants take part. It's an event to help the hungry in Manatee County. And finally, candy giant Hershey is looking to strike gold with its first new candy bar under the Hershey banner in more than 20 years. This is Hershey's Gold, well named. Hershey describes the Gold Bar as a whole new flavor for the company. Gold Bar mixes buttery sweet caramelized cream with crunchy bits of pretzels and peanuts. Hershey says the bar will go on sale nationwide next month. Gold is the fourth bar under the Hershey banner, that's all, joining the classic Hershey Bar, Special Dark, and Cookies and Cream Bar. Oh, that classic bar, good.
Wow.
I like to dip that classic bar in peanut butter.
Oh, yeah. Nothing wrong with that. Peanut butter and chocolate.
Yeah.
And my wife has worked in Hershey from time to time, and she says it's a really remarkable town because the whole town is centered around, of course,
oh, I bet.
Hershey's. There's
yeah.
chocolate everywhere, flowing yeah. in the streets.
Is that right?
Chocolate, just about.
My first job out of college was in Hackettstown, New Jersey, where M&M Mars is based.
Ah.
So you could smell the chocolate in the air some nights.
Ah, that's a good smell, I would imagine.
And half the city.
I wouldn't mind that.
Half the city worked for them.
Right.
And talking to them on camera was like getting the Pentagon on camera. Stay away.
Oh, they don't want to give away any trade secrets.
No press, please. Yeah. More on John's great weekend forecast, local traffic, and plenty of local news headlines after this. Stay with us.